Up once again, the light continues to blink. Off they go. They're away and they're racing. Deep out, Art of Consent bounced out of the gates very quickly, along with Trespassing, Just Adora Bill. Princess Du Jour from the inside tracking through, settling behind them. Fashion Stakes pulling its way forward. There is Weaponized, very fierce in the early part of proceedings. King's Parade down on the inside of that pair. Rock on Molly, Delta Ann and Winning Aces all go back, and towards the tail is Tin Chooks. By the 700 they go, and it's Art of Consent just in front of Uncle Gerard, who's gone up to sit at its outside. 1.5 to Madame Pro. Then Princess Du Jour travelling fourth, 3/4 of a length away. Then came Fashion Stakes. Trespassing had got back and stranded 3 deep under some pressure coming into the turn. Around it, Weaponize. Rock on Molly's near the rail. Just Adora Bill is well back in the field. So's Trespassing, Delta Ram, Winning Aces. Last of all is Tin Chooks. Art of Consent with a kick at the 220. Drew a length and a half. Uncle Gerard, 2 lengths behind them. Princess Du Jour followed down the outside by Fashion Stakes, who's running on. Art of Consent in front, and now here comes King's Parade. King's Parade is starting to really gather them up. King's Parade. King's Parade went 2 to their 1 late. Beat Art of Consent, Uncle Gerard or Fashion Stakes. Behind them, Princess Du Jour, Rock on Molly, Delta Ran, Madame Pro, Weaponized, Tin Chooks, Trespassing next in. Beat a few to the line, including Just Adora Bill, who gave naught. Winning Aces, and it is the last of them to greet the judge. King's Parade's the winner, ridden by Clint Johnston Porter, the impending 3-year-old. King's Parade in 1:10.24. 1:10.24 they've run, and the interim placings are 8 King's Parade, 9 Art of Consent, 5 Uncle Gerard, and 6 Fashion Stakes. 8, 9, 5, 6, the interim numbers here after the running of the 5th event for the day. Really got its mind on the task late. Knuckled down well, this 3-year-old, by impending from Queen's Parade for Darren McAuliffe and Impressive Racing and Partners, and written by Clint Johnston Porter. Finishing too well in the latter stages. Getting home to score from Art of Consent, which has led them running for a long way, by Pro Art out of By Mutual Consent, Sean and Jake Casey, Brad Parnham, and Uncle Gerard third home by Alfred Nobel from Classy Marcy, ridden by Austin Galati for trainer Jason Pateman. Fashion Stakes fourth in. Trespassing did naught, and neither Just Adora Bill. So 35.33, the last 600 there, off a time of 1:10.24 there to the 5th race for the day. Lightly raced 3-year-old. 2 wins already, though, recorded from his 5 career starts. King's Parade, he looks to be a developing type as well for the DMAC yard. Good win. Conceded the leader about a 4 to 5 length head start at the 200 metre mark, and really got going late, and certainly indicating as though a little more ground again would not be beyond him the way that he finished off. Race 6 is the Glenroy Chaff Handicap over the 1200 at 4:28, and there are no changes to come in the next on the program. Here's Lockie Taylor. He joins us down in the yard. Quite sure whether or not it was the one up pouring away at the front of the gates there for a split second, but it certainly looked as though it was. Anyway, got the job done regardless, and he looks to be a nice horse in the making, King's Parade.
Certainly does, Darren. He didn't get away all that cleanly, and he looked like he was in a tricky position throughout, but it looks like it's a nice horse, Darren, and a nice sign of things to come. When a horse can overcome a track pattern that's occurring today, it looks like you have a nice horse on your hands.
Yeah, look, we were. Oh well, I certainly was concerned when he was stepped a bit slow, but he messed around the gates. I did tell Clint to have someone up with him, but I did see him go up before they let them go. But yeah, got away slowly and just ended up back amongst them, and I was sort of a bit concerned then. But yeah, he's a classy individual, and he's going to win a lot more races.
When he eventually got into clear air at around the 300 metre mark, were you always confident that he had the ability to let down and be in the finish in the manner in which he did?
Well, probably not the way the track's been playing, in all honesty. You know, like, I mean, there's been some nice horses trying to run on, and they're just not capable of doing it. But look, you know, he's better than average, so we've just not been able to really find the right races for him. It's the program's just been a nightmare for a horse like him that's not quite at stakes grade yet. But anyway, look, hopefully going forward there's a couple on the program for him that we can sort of pick our way through.
Buzz, the sounds of things, he's a horse that you have a big opinion of behind the scenes. Does he head to a Saturday now?
We'll wait and see. It's probably program dictated. I mean, like, he was in Saturday grade last start, but we had to drop back to 1,000. You know, he's probably looking well and truly for a 14 or even a mile. But we'll see what the programmers do for us, and we'll have a look going forward.
And a word on the Velvet Queen ahead of the Ted Van Himps on Saturday?
Yeah, look, nice race for her. Small field that's going to play in her hands. As long as she doesn't get pocketed down on the inside. I was pretty happy with gate three when they came out, and then all of a sudden I'm in my nemesis gate one. So I can't win a toss with her at the moment. It's either gate one or gate bloody 16. So Paddy will do his job, and look, if she gets clear air, she'll certainly outsprint this lot. But yeah, I'm confident she'll run the trip. So I'm very, very happy with her.
Well done, and good luck on Saturday afternoon.
Thank you.
There's Darren McAuliffe, and here's CJP catching up with Scotty.
Well, Clint, first things first, what happened out of the gates? Because we could all see you're a little bit slow or awkward or all sorts was happening.
Yeah, he was playing up a little bit. He reared just before jumping, ended up pushing up against the front of the gates, and it just made me jump a bit awkward. Pretty much I come back and open the gates, and yeah, he was pretty much the last one out, but ended up in a good spot following the favourite.
It's amazing how that happens, isn't it? You can miss away and then all of a sudden end up in a nice spot and running.
Yeah, definitely. I planned to be in front of them ones I was following, but I ended up behind them, and it was for the best in the end.
The gap's nicely at the top of the home straight.
Yeah, he's an honest horse and he tries really hard, and when the gaps appeared, I had a horse underneath me to do it, so.
What are you expecting today from its closing in? She's first time out to the staying trip this time in. She obviously proved herself over winter that she's up to this level.
Yeah, her run was good the other day. She just needs the trip now, and she's got it, so hopefully she's good enough.
Best of luck. Well done.
Thank you.
There's Clint Johnson-Porter combining with Darren McAuliffe and King's Parade to take out the Bisley Workwear Handicap.